Dear fellows, the newly adopted integrated curricular reform going on in Egypt nowadays necessitates the introduction of early clinical exposure because besides understanding the clinical relevance, it prepares undergraduate students for clinical practice. Since ECG plays a key role in the diagnosis of cardiovascular disease, my project is about early clinical exposure in learning cardiovascular physiology. The project was applied on second-year medical students of the 2019 Extended Modular Program batch of Ain Shams University during the nine-week period of the cardiovascular module. Now, before the start of the project, pre-module orientation took place through email and Moodle, as well as through an orientation session. The ECG early clinical exposure was accomplished in the form of a six-step approach as follows. The first step was in the form of delivery of blended physiology lectures that were divided into two groups. The first group of lectures addressed the normal ECG, whereas in the second group, the pathophysiology of ECG was tackled. Now, before each group of lectures, students watched related videos, and before and after watching these videos, students answered similar MCQs related to the subject of the videos. The second step was in the form of a hands-on lab exposure for recording and interpretation of ECG. And the third step was in the form of delivering integrated lectures with cardiology staff members, during which ECG was tackled from the clinical point of view. Step four included patient visits, during which students met patients and commented on their ECGs. In step five, students shared in case-based discussions and in interpretation of their related ECGs with staff members from different disciplines, including cardiology members. And the final step of the approach was a forum opened for students to discuss and train on ECG interpretation with cardiology staff members. The impact of this intervention, along with the perception of learners, was assessed using the following metrics. Knowledge and skills were assessed by analyzing the results of the pre and post video MCQs, the MCQs for the continuous modular assessment, and the case-based, the case-related ECGs for the end of modular exam. Student feedback was assessed by performing student questionnaire as well as a focus group. And here is a picture of the conducted focus group. The results showed the following. There was a significant increase in the mean score of the post-video MCQ compared to pre-video scores, as shown here in these two figures. And this denotes significant enhancement of the knowledge by videos. There was also a significant increase in the mean scores of the MCQ of continuous modular assessment of the 2019 batch compared to the 2018 one. Moreover, the percentage of students who got the full mark at the end of the semester exam was significantly higher in the 2019 batch compared to the 2018 one. In addition, about two-thirds of the students were satisfied with the approach as a whole, and they would recommend the implementation of the approach in the new curriculum. We can conclude that the ECG early clinical exposure six-step approach significantly enhanced the students' knowledge and skills about the topic, as well as their endorsement of such learning activities in the new curriculum. Thank you.